Well, hello there. This is Frank Zappa, and with me tonight is the dynamic Captain Beefheart. Would you please say hello to everyone, Donnie?
Hello.
We're sitting here attempting to do a radio show, which will be sent out across the United States to anybody stupid enough to put it on the air. And the music that you hear in the background is a song called Cucamonga from the Bongo Fury album. Cucamonga from the Bongo Fury album. What we're going to do is just sit around here and play an assortment of records that we would enjoy listening to, and if you enjoy listening to them, then you'll probably stay tuned, and if you don't, you'll probably go away. What do you got there, Don?
Well, just the lyrics to one of those albums.
Was that from the Trap Mask album?
Yeah, Like Minor Cows.
Why don't you... You want to do a version of Orange Claw Hammer live in the studio?
Yeah.
Thick cloud caught a piper cub's tail, a match struck blue on a railroad rail. The old puff horse was just pulling through, and a man wore a pig leg forever. I'm on the bum where the hobos run, the air breaks with filthy chatter. Oh, I don't care, there's no place there, I don't think it even matters. My skin's blazing through and my clothes in tatters. And the railroad looked like a Y up the hill of letters. One shoe fell on the gravel, one stick poked down. Gravies fell down on a pair of ears. An eagle shined through my whole watch pocket. Gingham girl, baby girl, passed me by in tears. And a jackrabbit raised his folded ears. A beautiful sagebrush jackrabbit. And an oriole sang like an orange, his breast full of worms, and his tail clawed the evening like a hammer. And his wings took air like a bomber. My rain can caught me a cup of water. When I got into town, I jobs, ma'am. Ah, your horse all fodder. I'm the roundhouse man I once was was your father. Little up the road, a Candy Strike barber pole, and above it read a sign, Painless Parker. Licorice twisted around under a fly, and a youngster cocked her eye. God before me, if I'm not crazy, is my daughter. Come, little one, with your little dimpled fingers, give me one. And I'll buy you a cherry phosphate. Take you down to the foaming brine and water. And show you the wooden tits on the goddess with a pole out full sail. Then tipped it away, your pig leg father. Shanghaied by a high-hat beaver mustache man and his pirate friend. I woke up in vomiting beer in a banana bin, in a soft lass with brown skin. Bore me seven babies with snapping black eyes and beautiful ebony skin. And here it is, I'm with you, my daughter. 30 years away can make a seaman's eyes, a roundhouse man's eyes, flow out salt water, salt water.
And now let's play a record.
Abracadabra, face is a witch, shit-ass Stalin, ain't that a bitch? Abracadabra, all that rich, and Lancashire Boulevard. Cover my entire bodice with Avon Cologne. And drive me to some relative's house in East L.A. Just so my skin clears up. Turn it to Channel 13 and make me watch the rubber tug when it comes out. From the puff and flavulence Mexican rebel goose mask. It's time they show the Bernaca. Make me buy the flosser. Make me grow brainiac fingers. But with more hair. Make me kiss your turquoise jewelry. Emboss me. Rub the hot front part of my head with rigid unguents. Give me boss relief. Cause the dance is me on my way.
something I could lay on. Can't remember what became of me. Carolina, hardcore ecstasy. She put a Doobie Brothers tape on.
Strange to Herb and Dee. Carolina hardcore ecstasy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now have a special treat for you. A new group direct from Hollywood, California, the Smegmates.
I will make water.
Well, I can get in your pants, house, little woman. You'll drink my water and I'll eat your pants.
Me got
suppose you're lost and working on phone boys.
Will you drink my water? I really think
you badger.
A squid eating dough in a polyethylene bag is fast and bulbous. Got me?
Sissies don't dare to glance. Yellow jackets and red devils buzz around her hair hive hole. She wears her past like a present, takes her fancy in the pants. A sedan skims along the floorboard. Her two pipes humming carbon car. Got her wheel out of a B-29 bomber. Brody knob amber, Spanish fringe and talcum tassels, forever amber. She looks like an old squaw Indian. She 99, she won't go down. Avocado green, alfalfa yellow, adorn her to the ground. Tattoos and tarnished utensils, a snow white bag full of tunes. Drives a cartoon around, drives a cartoon around. Roma sells a blue umbrella, keeps her up off the ground. Round red sombreros wrap her high-tap horse and shoes. When she unfolds her umbrella, Pachuco's got the blues. Her loving make me so happy, if I smile, I crack my chin. Her eyes are so peaceful, thinks it's heaven she been. Her skin is as smooth as a daisy's in the center where the sun shines in. Smiles as sweet as honey. Her teeth as clean as the combs where the bees go in. When she walks, flowers surround her. Let their nectar come into the air around her. She loves, her love sticks out like stars. Her loving stick out like stars.
a teenage mod shop. Kids, it's your old friend Captain Beefheart. You know me, the magic man, invisible and all that jazz. Fly through time and space, dimension warp, all that rhythm. Well, anyway, I'm here tonight to tell you that we have a heck of a little teenage opera for you. You're really going to dig it. Yes, it's really groovy. Fellow that we see approaching the studio is named Ned the Mumbler.
I'm new at your high school. No teenage girl to call my name. I'm new at your high school. No teenage girl to call my name. Just cause my daddy done work for the government, I changed schools so that's a crying shame. Just a mumbling round your school, yeah, wishing someone knew my name. I'm just a mumbling round your school, yeah, I'm wishing someone knew my name. Lord knows I need some friendship till it hurts me. Why can't these people feel my pain?
Boldly he steps through the door.
Look at these little teenage girls, they go for a football man. I'll have to show them just what's shaking, let them know just who I am.
Ned's marvelous. He's not nearly as marvelous as I am, of course, but he's a kind of a teenage lone ranger.
My name is Ned the Mumbler, and I ain't gonna lie. 'Cause I've been all over the country, been here and all around. I've used my secret power in every kind of town. Now my fortune brings me here, and the logical thing to do is take my secret power and use it on one of you.
So far in the first half hour, you have heard a live in the studio version of Orange Claw Hammer, a selection from the Trotmass Replica album, also from Trotmass Replica. You've heard Pachuco Cadaver, some selections from the Bongo Fury album, a live performance by the Smegmates and Heavy Friends. And you just listened to some parts from side two of the 10-record set of the history and collected improvisations of the Mothers of Invention. That piece was the demos that we presented to CBS for the first rock and roll teenage opera. I was a teenage malt chop. And now...
Hello there, hello there. This is Frank Zappa.
There, there. This is Captain Beefheart.
And you're listening to WLIR, Long Island.
Ha-ha! Ned has a brainstorm.
This is the original version of Toads of the Short Forest. This was recorded in 1964 in Cucamonga.
You can do on the piano if you have one around. If you get tired of playing Home on the Range by Colors, we used to do this when we were younger. You have to learn two different kinds of backgrounds. You can do them both in the key of C and you'll be all right. The first one is like this. That one's pretty easy to master. And then there's another one which isn't too tricky either. Now those backgrounds, those two backgrounds will work for, oh, I think it's a total of 15,000 different rock and roll songs that you can all sing at parties.
Jive, I love you through and through. I loved you since in grammar school when we were sniffing glue. I loved you, pretty baby darling. I don't know what in the world to do about it. Ba 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 ba. But you are, Jarva, my darling, the only love I have. I hope you will forgive me, dear, for punching out your dad. I loved you, and I don't know what in the world I'm gonna do about it. Oh, lum-ba-bum-bum, I remember,
we'll be right back.
Speed Freak Boogie from the as-yet-unreleased 10-record set, The History and Collected Improvisations of the Mothers of Invention. Before we play anything else from that album, I think I'd like to get Don to tell what he remembers about working in Cucamonga. Why don't you describe that studio?
It was a little black cardboard stucco place that was right next to a nursery, wasn't it?
It was a shoe store on one side and then Citrus Electric on the other side, and across the street was a Holy Roller Church and a grammar school. And right down the street was an Italian restaurant, a hardware store, a pub called Shanty Devlin's, a Bank of America, the Cucamonga Malt Shop, and all the important places of the area. The population of the town at that time was about 7,500. Do you remember the night we recorded that thing, Middle Man Has Won His Wings?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we're going to play that next. I thought you might want to... Well, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll play it, and then you can explain to everybody how the lyrics to the song came about. Now, this was recorded in 1964, and maybe it was even 63. I'm not sure.
63.
Yeah. Well, I took it into Hollywood and tried to sell it to a real live record company. And they listened to it. And they said, well, I'm sorry, we can't do anything with that because the guitar is distorted.
Studio Z with, and on the wall, all of these things were written all over the wall, and I just started reading them.
Yeah, stereo in those days consisted of the band on one track and the vocalist on the other so that you could control it, and we had the band in the main part of the room, and Don was standing out in the hall. The name of the group was The Suits, spelled S-O-O-T-S, and the company that rejected the record for having a distorted guitar was Dot.
Boy, that's great.
Milt Rogers was the A&R man that listened to it in abject disgust. Of course, he was right, you know, it never would have been a hit. Why don't we play some more stuff from that 10-record set, and then we'll just jump forward in time and slap in something else from the Trout Mask album and see how the sound matches up. Just turn it back on wherever you got it.
Friends don't mind just how you grow.
Well, that would be bad for his daughter.
Right.
But they signed you anyway. That was your first record company.
No, they wouldn't take that record.
They wouldn't take that one, but you put up Diddy Wah Diddy on there. Now, that was safe for his daughter.
That was a real safe.
The thing that's in the background right now is the tape that we made the night before the cops came in and raided the studio in Cucamonga. Trouble's just begun. How appropriate. As it segues into the next item, this piece of music was recorded at a party in Hollywood. It was the first time the Mothers of Invention had appeared in the civilized world. We had made our emergence from the Pomona area into Hollywood, and we were the entertainment at a party that they were using in conjunction with the filming of a picture called Mondo Hollywood. The amplifier that the bass is playing through was lent to us by Jim Gersio. And meanwhile, over on the side, watching the band for some sort of future purpose, was Herbie Cohen, who eventually turned out to be our manager.
Sound of the Mothers of Invention.
is the ultimate bootleg record. That's it. This is a recording at one of the first rehearsals of the Mothers of Invention. This is Ray Collins, Roy Estrada, and Jimmy Carl Black. As you can see, they're trying to figure out the words to Rock Around the Clock.
Is that right, Jim? You never heard G?
Yeah, I never heard
it.
Seriously.
What reservation was that?
One,
two, three.
Well, back in those days,
they
didn't have electricity.
Oh, it's in the middle.
There's some old trap there for you.
Hey, oh, G. Coca Pony Wanna G.
Yes, they just stood around mumbling at each other in those days.
Once I had some cheese.
Cheesy baby.
They made a sandwich.
Imagine people seriously rehearsing how to sing. Once I had
some cheese. Once I had some cheese.
Made a sandwich.
Abstract. This is the first rehearsal of How Could I Be Such a Fool, just before we made the Freakout album.
When I won your love, I was very glad. Every happiness in the world belonged to me. Then our love was lost, and you went away. Now I shed my tears in love. I know now that you never ever really loved me. It hurts me now to think you never ever really cared. I sit and ask myself a thousand times to try and find what really happened to the love that we shared. How could I be such a fool? All those lies you told me. How can I be taken in by your sweet face? Spoil our love. You ruined my life. I'm so fucked up. I'm a terrible disgrace. But there will come a time and you'll regret the way you treated me as if I was a fool.
Missed a beat that time, didn't
he?
This rehearsal took place in 1968. This is when we had a 10-piece band. The name of this song is Boogie for Berkeley. It was never released on a record. As a matter of fact, it was only performed in concert twice. Oh, that's too distorted to put on the radio.
Lucid tentacles test in sleeve and join in jointed jade pointed diamondback patterns. Neon meat dream of a octafish. Artifact on rose petals, in flesh petals and pots. Fact in feast, in tubes, tubs, bulbs, ingest, incest, ingest, ingest, in feast, incest. In specks, in speckled, 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 speculation. bedlocks, waddling feet, arcade faces frenzy, ceramic fists, artificial decease, insist rancid buds burst, dank crumb and dung dust, meat rows and hairs, meaty, meat rows and hairs, meaty, dream, wet, meat, limp, damp rows, peels in felt, fields in belts, impaled on in daemon, mucus mules, clot, trot, tra-la, 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 whalebone, fields in belts, whalebone farmhouse, cavorts girdled in ladders alight, cavorts girdled in ladders alight, a dip amidst squirming serum in semen in syrup in semen in serum, stirrup in syrup. Neon meat dream of a octopus.
You've been listening to America. Well, I guess that about wraps it up for tonight, boys and girls. You're going to take this out with part of the Muffin Man. The Muffin Man is seated at the table in the laboratory of the Utility Muffin Research Kitchen. Reaching for an oversized chrome spoon, he gathers an intimate quantity of dried muffin remnants, and brushing his scapular aside, proceeds to dump these inside of his shirt. He turns to us and speaks.
Some people like cupcakes better. I, for one, care less for them.
Arrogantly twisting the sterile canvas snoot of a fully charged icing anointment utensil, he puts forth a quarter-ounce green rosette. Let's try that again. He puts forth a quarter-ounce green rosette near the summit of a dense but radiant muffin of his own design.
Later, he says,
Some people like cupcakes exclusively, while myself, I say, there is not, nor ought there be, nothing so exalted on the face of God's gray earth as that prince of foods, the muffin.
Girl, you thought it was a man, but it was a muffin. He hung around till you found that he didn't know nothing. A man, but he only was a puffin. No cries was heard in the night as a result of him stuffing.
trombone, Napoleon Murphy Brock on tenor sax and lead vocals, Terry Bozio on drums, Tom Fowler on bass, Denny Wally on slide, George Zook on keyboards, Captain Beefheart on vocals and soprano sax and madness. Thank you very much for coming to the concert tonight. Hope you enjoyed it. Good night, Austin, Texas, wherever you are.
Acetate of a song that is going to be on the album that comes out in November.
Uh-huh.
And this, the reason I want to play this for you is because it's got Captain Beefheart and myself singing together on it. And it's a bicentennial song. It's a song that deals with the celebration of our country's 200th anniversary. And I figured that it was time that I did a song about our country's 200th anniversary. I've done several since this. Which will be revealed a little bit later. This is the first of my bicentennial tunes.
Amen. Is this dedicated to any particular... Is this for Concord and Lexington?
No, this is for everybody who's managed to live through the last 200 years.
Amen again. This is called 200 Years Old, and it's from later this year.
Sitting in a breakfast room in Allentown, Pennsylvania. 6 o'clock in the morning. Got up too early. It was a terrible mistake. Sitting there face to face with a 75-cent glass of orange juice about as big as my finger and a bowl of horribly foreshortened corn flakes. And I said to myself, this is the life.
Is it 200 years old?
She tried to grow a mustache. We'll be right back.
We can't hear that.
Right, it's fading. It's Frank Zappa.
It is not.
It's Captain Beefheart singing, playing harmonica, and Frank Zappa singing and playing guitar. And it's called 200 Years Old.
It's not fading.
But we got to do a break, unfortunately.
Just the wallpaper, man.
Just take a break. Come on, take a break. Play a commercial.
I just want to ask, now, that you're going to be playing that kind of material tonight?
Yeah, there are some things like that tonight.
Well, okay, now.